and CDM Smith have a hopeless conflict of interest. Do you know, is it not obvious that they have a hopeless conflict of interest because they're involved with the oil and gas companies?
First of all, they have signed conflict of interest.
What do you mean they've signed conflict of interest?
Just maybe if I read out exactly what they signed up to.
Can you just summarise it? I mean, do they not have a hopeless conflict of interest, given their association with the oil and gas industry?
As I've indicated to you, we specifically looked for expertise for those in geology, hydrogeology, and particularly in hydraulic fracturing. I've already indicated that CDM, particularly, 5,000 employees, they advise a whole slew of clients, including regulators, countries, and private entities. They have advised on the pro-fracking side in terms of Poland, and on the anti-fracking side in terms of Germany and some of the German states. And this is the same issue that you will find with any large consultancy, any large legal firm, any large accountancy firm. They provide a service of technical integrity that is then used by various people for other purposes.
Well, can I just put it to you that they don't? AMEC is part of the Marcellus Shale Coalition, right? That is a pro-fracking coalition. Can I read to you from the AMEC website? Our customers in both the private and public sector are among the world's biggest and best in their fields. BP, Shell, BR, Petrobras, KNPC, Suez, ExxonMobil, the list goes on, right? How can you seriously suggest that these people are independent, or sorry, you're not saying they're independent, but that they don't have an absolutely massive, overwhelming conflict of interest?
Well, I repeat, and we are aware, and I've provided this committee, that AMEC is a member of the Marcellus Shale Coalition, an industry group that has developed best practice guidance for shale gas extraction in North America. We're totally aware of that. We're also aware that CDM were a member of the Marcellus Shale Coalition and resigned from that in 2010, 2011. I'm also aware that we required the CDM, the lead parts of this consortium, to sign conflicts of interest. And could I just say, before we say that the work that they're doing has to meet a scientific integrity, has to meet the requirements of people like the British Geological Society, UCD, University of Ulster, and Philip Lee.
Look, listen, My time is running out. I just don't accept this, right? I mean, here we look at, under all the headings, ground surface and water study undertaken by CDM Smith, water requirements for fracking, CDM Smith, faults and fractures, CDM Smith, the air monitoring, CDM Smith, water impacts and mitigation measures, CDM Smith, CDM Smith, life cycle assessment, environmental links, CDM Smith, and it goes on and on. AMEC, in some cases, AMEC and CDM Smith are not only doing the study, but they're also reviewing their own study. Is that they absolutely dominate this entire process? Isn't it simply the case this is a corrupted process?
As I said this morning, I said that the primary contributors to the overall research project in terms of staff resources are CDM Smith Ireland and the British Geological Survey. I said that in my opening statement today, but I'm also saying that we have provided a scope that has been evaluated by 27 members from 12 or 13 different regulatory agencies to ensure that the quality of the research meets international standards, is scientifically expert and robust, and will stand on its own two feet. But it'll be up, as we have not produced any reports associated of this research. When the final research outputs are prepared, it will be up to others to see have we succeeded in providing world-class, peer-reviewed and robust research.
Okay, well, look, I made the point, but I put it to you that this whole exercise is completely compromised from the word go by the involvement of these guys in it and their predominance at every level in the thing. And they are clearly people with a very, very strong interest in the fracking going ahead. Can I just ask, what is the purpose of this study?
The purpose of this study is to evaluate what the environmental impacts and the health impacts associated with hydraulic fracturing in an Irish context are.
In an Irish context? Okay, can you explain to me how, if in New York the Department of Health has said they don't believe, on public health grounds, it is safe to allow fracking. How could it be safe in Ireland?
I have no idea. I'm going to await the outcome of that research to tell me what the issue is. I know for particular that the particular hydrogeological and geological situation in northwest Ireland is much more complex. And you may find that not only will they collaborate the New York study, but also will say that it is a particularly sensitive area or the opposite. I don't know, but that's why we're commissioning this research, so we will know.
Well, I'll just quote you what they said. Department of Health's report concludes that it will be years until science and research provide sufficient information to determine the level of risk from high-volume hydraulic fracking poses to public health and whether those risks can be adequately mitigated. In other words, they're operating the precautionary principle. In other words, they're saying there is no way anybody, based on the current level of scientific knowledge of this area, can guarantee that there will not be adverse impacts on health, and we could throw in water and the environment as well. I mean, they say health, but isn't that just a fact?
That may well be the case, but a lot of research that EPA would have commissioned is taking international research and then looking at it from an Irish context, particularly given that there is that under current legislation, anyone who does fracking in Ireland will have to go through a series of hoops, including the Department of Communications Natural Resources and Bord Pleanála, the Commission of Energy Regulation, the Health Safety Authority, and the EPA. Those decisions have to be based on science. Our research will provide that science, and the science then can also inform not only policymakers, but the localities in which the research is done, so they can be fully informed.
I mean, that's a very long answer. How could it be safe from a public health point of view in Ireland if it's not in New York?
Well, what I would say to you is that you have to look at the study that preceded this research study, where we did an evaluation of international literature. It indicated that there are a lot of situations in the States where hydraulic fracturing can be done, a lot of situations where it can't be done, and advised the EPA that the prudent thing to do was to commission research that would put hydraulic fracturing and its impacts on environment and human health in an Irish context. And that's what we do. That's what we look at. We look at controversial research as well as non-controversial research. And we feel, as part of our role as the primary environmental researcher and funder of research in Ireland, that it is prudent that we look at this ongoing controversial issue and try and put some science into the debate.
But is this not science, what they're saying in New York?
It is, and we're also going to develop science.
But you actually said there's no public health assessment in your thing. Isn't that what you said?
No, I did not say that.
So are you going to be able to tell us at the end of this report if there's a danger to health?
If I could respond to the question you said, what I indicated was there will be no health impact assessment completed as part of this research. That's what I said.
There will be no health impact assessment completed. So you, at the end of this, you will not be able to tell us whether it's safe or not for our health?
No. What we will be able to say is what the impacts associated on the environment are. This will not recommend either for or against fracking, but it will start to put together the science that will allow others, including the EPA, to evaluate whether or not fracking should go ahead in Ireland. And that includes policymakers and legislators also. It will also provide for an assessment of what has worked well in other countries to develop a health impact assessment.
Do you not think what people actually just want to know is it safe or is it not safe for public health? That's what we need to know. And what you're really saying to us is, after all of this, we won't know whether it's a threat to public health. Although in New York they can tell us.
What we will provide is the research in an Irish context that will let us know what are the issues associated with environment and health associated with hydraulic fracturing, and that is worth doing.
Okay, you have 12 minutes, Deputy, so I want to Deputy Fleming, followed by Deputy Bannon.
First of all, Chairman, I just welcome the members here today, the witnesses, and I would first of all question the wisdom of carrying out even this particular study, because first of all the cost, which I've got